Welcome to our channel. In the previous sessions, we have discussed what is operator overloading, what are the rules to be followed to perform operator overloading. Okay, in this process, the first step is we have to create an operator function. How operator function is created? The operator function is created as a friend function or a member function, and at the same time we can perform operator overloading on unary operators or binary operators. So now consider the four cases: member function, friend function, unary operators, binary operators. Then four cases comes into existence. What is this? If operator function is created as a member function and perform operator overloading on unary operators, and function as a member function overloading on binary operators, member function completed. Now friend function with unary operator, friend function with binary operator. So four cases comes into play. Now in this session we will discuss how an operator overloading is performed for the unary minus. For which symbol? Unary minus as a member function. In the next session we will discuss as a friend function. What is the rule to be followed? In case of unary operators, as a member function, no arguments is to be created. We discussed in the rules, if it is a unary operator and implemented as a member function, no arguments are passed to the operator function. Before going to that one, what is unary minus? Unary minus simply negates the value. Unary minus simply negates the value. For example, if a is equal to 5, then minus a is equal to simply minus 5. This is unary minus. This is unary minus. Now, up to now, this unary minus is performed on, unary minus is performed on arithmetic types. What do you mean by arithmetic types? The normal integers and floats, etc. Unary minus is performed on arithmetic types. Now it is overloaded. Now it is overloaded to apply on object. This is the important. That means the overloading on user defined data type. Simply, class is a user defined data type, object is an instance of type class. So up to now we are performing overloaded on arithmetic type. Now what do you mean by overloading? Overloading means the same unary minus is applied to object. That is means overloading. The unary minus is applied to object, then generally the object contains arithmetic types. Even though if you are applying an object, the object itself contains arithmetic types. This is overloading. And remember the point here, whatever operation we are using, that is, if you are using unary minus, simply negates the value. For example, plus plus, that is increment operation, minus minus, decrement operation, the procedure is completely same. Now I will explain the procedure. What is the syntax? The first step is you have to create an operator function. Return type is void. Return type is void. The keyword is operator. And what is the operator symbol? The operator symbol is minus. And how many number of parameters? This is unary and member function. So no parameters. No parameters. For example, consider some variable value. Automatically it becomes this one. This is the operator function that we create in our program. Why? Because it does not return any value. Operator is a keyword. On which symbol we are performing operation? Minus. So this is the operation. For example, okay, this is clear. For example, if you are performing operator overloading on plus plus, what to do? Instead of this one, you can write like this, plus plus. What happens for plus plus? Simply plus plus value, that is the value is incremented. If minus 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 minus, okay, whatever the operation, the original meaning of the operator is not modified. Remember that point. We cannot redefine the original meaning, and we cannot modify the syntax, and we cannot modify the precedence and associativity. Everything we have to use same as arithmetic types. The only difference is we perform this overloading concepts to object also. Now consider an example program to discuss each and every point, and a simple example. Class sample read a variable into value public void read of c in value void display of c out value. A simple example. That is, by using read function I am reading the value, and by using the display function I am displaying the value. Now I am creating an operator function in this program. See, the class is not completed. Void operator minus of, void operator minus of simply value is equal to minus value. Now the class is closed. Now how to perform overloading? See the main. Int main, create an object for sample class, sample s. First step, s dot read of. So by calling this one, we are call the read function. By writing this statement, we call the read function. In this, we are reading some value. Assume I am reading a value 5. I read a value 5. Now s dot display. Whenever you are call the display function, the value in the display function is printed. Now what is printed? Value 5 is printed. Now the question is, perform operator overloading on object. What is the object? The object is s. Simply you can write like this, minus s. If you write like this, this is operator overloading. Now call the function s dot display close. If you call the function s dot display, then what is output? The output is minus 1. Now operator overloading is performed. Actually, here we are writing like this, but how the system calls? System calls like s dot operator minus of. Okay, we are writing only this statement. If you are writing this statement, system calls like this. So system calls like s dot operator. Okay, this is operator overloading on unary operator. So the same concept. Suppose if you are using plus plus, here you can write plus plus, here also you can write plus plus. In that case, the same s dot operator of plus plus of, s dot operator space plus plus of. This is operator overloading on unary minus by using member function. In the next session, we will discuss the same unary operator using friend function.